Hello, welcome back to Ocarina Time Master Quest, and today I'm going to be taking on Dodongo's Cavern, which is the second dungeon of Master Quest. But a lot has changed throughout this dungeon. In fact, near enough everything has changed throughout this dungeon, other than the mini boss and the actual boss, pretty much. The entire puzzle sequence of this dungeon has definitely been changed. I mean, even this main room, this wasn't the way to proceed in the original game. I'm not really sure how many of you have even played Master Quest before, but I'm assuming everybody that normally, like, I don't know, would play Ocarina of Time and not Master Quest and have never played Master Quest probably just looked it out and went, what the hell? At that. So, like, even this, those rocks, they aren't there. Normally, they're not there anyway. There's another switch at the end of here. I'm not sure if there's a switch up here normally. There's something up here. I don't recall what though. But yeah, this is how you open the door in this version. Just top down. Turn over here. I have a tendency of going in the wrong direction. Like in the opposite direction, like from left to right in this dungeon, just because of how recently I've played the 3DS version of Master Quest. So I tend to walk right when I mean to go left, and vice versa sometimes for this dungeon. Tell you the truth, I'm not 100% wanting to record today, but it's been a couple of days since I've uploaded a video, so we may as well get one out of the way, and it might as well be a dungeon. I really hate dealing with bomb players in this game, just because I never meant to take my bug out of the bottle either. The hitbox on bomb players, when it comes to the N64 games, or at least the ports of the N64 games, I'm pretty sure this happens in the original production cart as well, but there's a hitbox on bombs, and like, they have a strange box when you're either behind them or inside of them, Link won't pick them up. Like, there's no action icon to pick them up, so you need to be standing at them in such a certain way where you can pick them back up again. For your normal bombs, the ones that you carry with you, that's not a problem, you just take them out and throw them. But for bomb players, it's a bit of a problem. The room that I like just kind of walked past down there, it contains a skulltula with a bunch of blocky times. I can't get a skulltula in there currently, because I don't have a song of time, obviously. So there's no point in me going in there to go ahead and to collect that skulltula, because I can't even get it right now. I need to block the song of time to remove the blocks to find the skulltulas. And that's the way Master Quest likes to do a lot of the skulltulas, is they like to put things that you would need later in the game to come back into the temples to get the skulltula to leave if you're going for 100%. It becomes quite tedious if you're going for skulltulas. And it's mainly throughout the kid era. When you get to the forest temple, they tend to stop doing that. I'm not sure why. Maybe somebody like a higher up in Nintendo thought it might have been a really annoying and irritating idea, which to be honest it is. I'm gonna take the shield stab power here and just walk up to the Dodongos and stab them. Just one hit them, because without the power of the Deku stick in my sword, I probably wouldn't kill them this quickly. We stop it. We stop doing that with the golden skull tools. We stop making you go back to previous temples eventually. There is a room in the spirit temple where there's a couple of skull tools, and you need to find a hidden key to be able to get into that room. And I think you need a key from the water temple. Like, correct me if I'm wrong, I may be 100% correct with this, but I remember there being an extra key inside of the water temple in Master Quest. And I think you actually need that key to open that door in the dungeon. I can't guarantee that, actually. I honestly can't guarantee that, but I know there is a second... Like, there's an extra key. I was about to say a second key, but there's like a bajillion keys for the Water Temple. There's an extra key in a Water Temple where there's a room where you need to fight three stealth forces. And I'll show it off, obviously. But it's really strange that it's there. And they never really give you a clear reason as to why you need it. For me, myself, I never really pay attention to how many keys I should have. If there's a locked door, then I go, oh, I left the key. And then I'll go back and go get it. I don't really pay attention to the key count on my screen, so I don't know if a Water Temple is the actual key that I'm trying to keep in my inventory to the point where I get to that room. I'm not really sure how they went around getting that, but it'll become clear enough, especially to me anyway, who obviously is very confused, as you can probably hear my voice, as to how you even get in that room, or why there is a second key, or not a second key, an additional key, the one that you don't even need to beat the temple and save the Water Temple. Skeletor is in this temple in particular, and there's a lot of them that you need either the boomerang or the song of time to be able to do anything in. Especially the room that I talked about earlier. It's full of blocky tanks, and there's nothing I can do about it. Some block time Skulltula puzzles, you can throw the boomerang, you know, go through the side of it and you can pick up the token. Just kind of by glitching it, I guess. But you can do it that way too. I sometimes do it on the ones that are really easy to do it on, but on that particular room, it's very hard to be able to kill without having the song time, mainly because of the distance between that block and where you're able to stand. I think it's more than possible to do as Adult Link, to glitch it and then not use the later block of time, but at that point you have the block of time, not the block of time, the song of time, so there's no point in even glitching it. It's just something you could do. Today is the 26th of December. It's one day after Christmas. I'm somewhat feeling the repercussions of being tired, I guess, from staying up most of Christmas and getting up when, like, relatively early for me. On a weekend, then it's relatively early. It was still Sunday at that point. And the fact that it's really Christmas weekend, so of course I'm probably gonna sleep for most of it. I don't know, I woke up at like 9-ish and just lay there for like an hour. And today, I didn't get up till like about 11:30. And that's really bad, to be honest, because that's like quite a bit of your day kind of wasted sleeping. But yeah, I'm not feeling 100% right this second. Just somewhat disorientated. Haven't used my voice much today, so you can probably hear it. But I'm not really sure what to say. Normally, my good videos happen when I've done like a lot of videos in a row, or when I'm just really in the mood where I'm like, yeah, let's go record. A lot of the time, it doesn't really happen like that. There's another Skulltula in this room. You probably noticed the box back there. But I can blow up and then walk over on at the top of the platform. You can do that, but I'm probably not going to do that until I have to come back here and get the rest of the Skulltulas inside of this temple, or dungeon rather. Because that Skulltula in itself is kind of annoying to get. You need to backtrack to be able to get that one. The reason I even equipped my Highwing shield here is because this flame, the platform that I'm standing on, or was standing on, that one there, it'll come back on eventually. I think it just did come back on. I'm not sure. Yeah, it did. Okay. So you can strike this again, and then the flame will go out, and then you step on this block, and then the other flame will go out, and I can get across. But yeah, I don't know, like I was saying, Skulltulus in the dungeons is a challenge, tedious to get, because you gotta go back towards them, you gotta use your equipment. There's even a Skulltulus inside the Deku Tree that you need the Song of Time to do. And I always forget, and I probably will forget, I'm gonna guess, but I'm gonna forget. But you're as well getting the Song of Time first, before you go ahead and get all the Skulltulus in the previous temples that you need to revisit. The Song of Time opens up a lot more doors in Master Quest than it did in Ocarina of Time, like in the original. Master Quest, it basically extends the gameplay by adding a lot of tedious elements into the game. Come on, come on. I think that's like the only way you can actually get that door open. I always think I'm gonna fail when I do that room, just because of the way that it's played out. Drop that there. I think there's a bomb flower inside. Yeah, there was. Damn it. Is that gonna grow when I'm standing this close, or is the hitbox really tight in this version? Yeah, it was really tight. I think a Master Quest on the 3DS just grows back and pushes you back if you're too close. A lot of people, like, in the original couple of parts of this, like 1 and 2, are still confused as to what the difference is of Master Quest and the original Ocarina of Time. Well, it's kind of obvious when you look at a dungeon. I mean, heck, I'm surprised half of them didn't realize by looking at a... I can't believe that didn't blow up. That's another thing I don't like about the original version of Ocarina of Time and Master Quest. They have this weird hitbox sensor where if you're not looking at something or you don't have the camera on something, then it doesn't blow up. Like, watch. Now it'll blow up. I bet you it will. Yeah, okay, now it blew up, but it didn't want to before because it wasn't in the hitbox. So the explosion didn't count because Link wasn't looking at it. I don't know, it's bad programming. The game is really nostalgic and everything, but it does have its flaws, and that's one of them. Forgot that I didn't blow this up. I don't think that would have blew up either if I wasn't looking at it. It tends to happen with blocks in the wall more so than anything, because in the original programming of Ocarina of Time, there was no rock and a ceiling. There's one skeletal in this room. Forget, what are you so? Revolution, nah. There was no original like block instead of a ceiling. So I guess the bomb trajectory just doesn't work unless you're using a bomb tube. Like, it doesn't activate, it doesn't confirm with the game's programming. I didn't take any damage from that, that was strange. It doesn't confirm with the game's programming that it should blow up, basically. Equip the Deku Shield. Do a jump attack. This is how I normally deal with them. It's way too easy this way, but this mini-boss is irritating because of the way that they dance around. If you look, they're dancing like between each other and they take forever to get to you. And if you approach them, they tend to run away. Like, for example, is he coming over here or what? Okay, now he is. But the other one ran away the moment I tried to approach. Which is what happens a lot, and then the other one will run away unless he thinks it's his turn to attack me. That's somewhat irritating. But yeah, there we go, we cleared them two out. Don't get me wrong, I love this game and everything, it's just, it has aged badly in programming, in terms of what you would think would work in today's video game logic, or just even logic in general. Like, I'm gonna have to watch this, because even the gravestone is a trigger in this. They hide a lot of stuff behind weird obstacles and weird environment things that they just really shouldn't do. because it was never in the original programming intention to be able to use them as such items, but the collision factor of them really comes into play. Like, I guess this was Nintendo's way of testing their own programming capabilities of saying, what can I do to this to make it 10 times more irritating than what it was a long time ago? Okay, well, that one did blow up. I can't remember. Did I? Yeah, I did activate this one. So I'm gonna have to go back here and see what was in this room. I think it's a Skulltula on the wall that I can't reach. Pretty sure. Oh yeah, and two mad scripts. I hear a bat. Ah! I had a funny feeling it was gonna be a fire key. Great. I lost my shield, but there is a salesman inside of this temple that'll sell you a new deck of shield if you carelessly lose one. And yeah, there is a golden skull shield in there, but I can't get it. I have no boomerang. So I'm gonna have to revisit this temple after I get a boomerang and the Song of Time. Even more irritating that I have to revisit because I have the Song of Time, but whatever. This game, in general, is probably one of the most finest reworks of a game that's ever been produced. But at the same time, it has no programming changes when it could have. But I suppose that's keeping to the original in such a way that they wanted to preserve all feelings of the original. I'm glad that they didn't do that in the 3DS version. Like, the 3DS version's a lot more solid. They took away many glitches that could be abused, like crouch stabbing, the power glitch with the Deku stick, infinite sword, and floating. I'm pretty sure the floating they took away as well, with bombs and stuff, with infinite sword glitch. I'm trying to think what else they took away. I'm not sure, actually. Is backpacking gone or swore? I think it may just be more difficult to do because you can kind of walk way back in diagonal a lot on the circle pad than you can walk straight back. But I don't think they removed backwalking being faster. I think they just made it more difficult to do because of the hitbox. I don't think that was even intentional. I think that's just the programming for the analog stick in a 3DS. So yeah, if you come all the way up here and you jump onto this, you can go ahead and hit the business scrub. I mean, you can talk to him, and if you have 50 rupees, you can buy a new shield. I have 122, so I really don't care. But we're just gonna leave now, because there's no point being in this room anymore, because I don't have a Song of Time, and I can't clear that out anymore. If you come over here, and you head all the way back up here, jump on top of this platform, walk all the way forward. Well, I guess I could just climb this ladder, but I was thinking about using the platform until it went up. Another thing that I was thinking of, actually, is thumbnails for this series. They're really hard to make because of the fact that the textures in-game aren't that sharp. They look kind of crappy, and you're probably going to notice it on the thumbnail for this episode. I'm going to use Elizaphos with the background of, like, this dungeon. And Elizaphos is green, and I'm like, he looks like I just went out of Photoshop and put a hue over the top of him. I can't find any 3DS, like, textures. I would really love to use the 3DS version textures for the thumbnails, but I can't find a resource that has all the 3DS textures. That'd be amazing if I could find that, because if I was sitting there going, I could use all this from, like, really high-res fan art and stuff like that, but I feel like I would have to credit the offer, like, of the individual drawings and everything else. Because that's not fair enough if, like, their work gets used elsewhere without their permission and they get no credit or mention. That's really unfair to them. I should probably equip a shield. Toss a bomb over here to activate this switch on the other side, and that'll make the fire go out. You can climb it, Or you can pull the grave back and claim it, and normally just claim over it. There's also a switch back there that you, well, you know, the bomb trail that leads up to a switch that creates the staircase. Might as well equip the shield now. I don't think there's anything important in here. I think it's just 5 rupees in a chest and the postal if you want it. But a postal is pointless in itself. There's no point getting it if you don't want it. Postal just doesn't have a purpose, really. I think this is the only way you can get on top of this little platform here, this little ridge, to get at Skeletula. I don't think you can get up here naturally other than doing a run jump off the stairs. I want to drink the entire milk, because there's a fairy in here, and as most people probably know in Ocarina of Time, the fairies are very, very broken. I think they heal you for full life in this game, but in most games they only heal you for about 6 to 8 hearts, maybe even 10 in some games, but in this game it heals you for all of your life, I'm pretty sure. Or at least 12 hearts or something like that. It's a lot of hearts anyway that you recover, more so than anything else other than the red potion. Milk used to be, and when I was a kid, it used to be probably considered to be one of the more favorable items to carry. I disagree. It only heals, I think it only heals 6 hearts, it might be 8 per drink. It's 2 replenishes, which is nice, so if you've only took a bit of damage, you could use it, but I feel like there's better items that you could use. King Dodongo is one of the weakest enemies or bosses in Zelda history. I don't think I've ever let him live for more than a minute, really. I tried to spawn too quickly. Fuck. Oh my god, and I missed. I barely ever let this happen. I'm gonna have to equip this shield because I don't want to lose my deck of shield again. Okay, right. He's just gonna roll back around again, and we're gonna have to repeat this process from this side. I took damage for myself, not from King Dodongo. That's pretty embarrassing, really. Come on, wait a second. Change. And he's dead. He goes down with 2 Deku Strikes. I just didn't want to waste a Deku Stick, even though I've got like 17 or something of them on him, because to be honest, I'd rather use that on an enemy that's threatening, not a boss that can't even hit you if you know what he's gonna do. So yeah, he's dead now. There's nothing to that at all, really. King Dodongo, you're the same enemy, the same boss, same everything. You're really boring. Goodbye. Thank you. Alright, so off we go and put a little pet down here where you can place a bomb, spell chill up there, everything else. That cutscene, when I was a kid, I always thought it was somewhat adorable how the Gorons really appreciate Link that much, where they like befriend him to the point where they call him like his sworn brother and everything. They kind of accept him as one of their own, like a little hero, I suppose, even though he's just a kid. I don't know, it's somewhat cool. Gorons have always been my favorite race in Zelda since the Ocarina of Time, mainly because of that cutscene, kinda, and the relationship that Dernia and Link eventually have over the fact of the course of destiny and everything. I think it's also mainly because it's the fact that Dernia now is really the only person that really sees Link as being an important part of any of the races in Zelda right now, other than the Deku Tree, who obviously could tell that Link was a child of destiny or whatever. Dernia and his race of Gorons seem to be the only person that really acknowledges that Link could potentially be the hero, or even a hero, because at this point I'm guessing we don't even know that Ganondorf exists or anything like that. No, well, they do actually, because Ganondorf was the one that came here demanding the ruby, and then the Dodongo, and whatever, like, he brought the Dodongo King back to life, and they basically had a famine here because of that. All because Dernia wouldn't give it to anybody other than the royal family, or somebody that proved himself worthy of taking it off of him. I mean, they are entrusted with it for a reason. You can't just give it to everybody, and you clearly didn't like Ganondorf. I really hate doing this, this particular little vase puzzle thing, minigame. It's irritating because I used to get this as a kid, and I never knew that you could actually get it wrong when I was younger. I never got it like this before. I would get it really easily when I was a kid. I would just throw a bomb, and all the time it would turn out to be the hearts. It would never turn out to be the money, the bombs, or money or bombs is really the only two other options you can get. It would never turn out to be anything like that. It would just always instantly be the heart piece, and I thought that was the way that you got a heart piece. You just threw a bomb in and you got a heart piece. I didn't know there was other options, I just thought that was it. But nowadays, I never get lucky the first time, and I always get the incorrect faces. I'm just sitting there like with my fingers crossed, trying to get the correct ones. Time, I really hate this stupid minigame. That must have taken me like 5 minutes or something to be able to get all that. It's not even a minigame, it's a chance at luck. If you get the right one, well, maybe it isn't. Maybe there is a certain, like, time or position where I throw the bomb or whatever, but I don't know. I've always did it to the point where I just throw the bomb, see what I get. So I'm waiting on the upgrade here because I need to wait for Goron to come behind here. Where is he? He's right there. So I'm gonna have to wait for him for a bit. When he gets to this little cave area here, you're gonna drop a bomb and see if he'll reach you on time. Damn, if that was a proper bomb player, he would have reached that on time. Okay, so I stopped him. I think he's inside enough for me to get a upgrade from him. Yeah, okay, he's giving me the bomb upgrade. That's fine. So now I can go ahead and unlock the rest of the areas around here. For example, where the Bigoran sword will be later on in the game. Well, not the Bigoran sword, the Giant's Knife, or whatever it's called. Giant's Knife? Giant's Knife. Pretty sure it's called the Giant's Knife. Just unlock this so I don't have to do it when I'm an adult and waste even more bombs. And bombs are a bit more required when you're an adult than when you are as a child. Especially in the dungeons, you don't really want to run out of bombs. 5 RP. Freaking Goron. Sometimes you'll notice little jitters here and there. I'm pretty sure, well, I noticed it. I don't know if you'll notice it just watching the video, but I'm pretty sure the capture device will even pick it up because it happened in real time on my TV too, where the game will just have it like a second frame drop and then it'll pick back up again. And it'll be fine. I mean, there's nothing particularly wrong with it, but it's just really meh. But it does that. I don't know. It's a bad port. That's pretty much it. The console in itself, the GameCube, is obviously stronger than what the N64 was, like a million times stronger. But in terms of emulation playing, I mean, this is an N64 game ported over. So, of course, it's being emulated by the GameCube in some manner or form. And the data is being processed like it's an N64 game. So, of course, it's somewhat frustrating to it to have to read the code. So, I don't know, it's just badly done, I guess. Or at least not perfectly done. Which it should be, because this game, not as particular port, but the collector's edition port of Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask, especially Majora's Mask, and Zelda 1 and Zelda 2 all tend to have crash frequencies, where the game will randomly crash. Majora's Mask especially, sometimes it'll happen when you're opening a chest or even when you're walking, the game will freeze. It happens in a Wii version too. I've had it happen when I was at the end of my cycle putting away my rupee, and then all of a sudden it froze in the bank manager and it makes a loud screeching noise. It goes, it'll take the last second of whatever you heard and then it'll amplify it throughout your speakers, and it just, it hurts your ear so much. I've always disliked this the way that it does the molten lava rock coming down from the volcano when it's apparently erupting. I've always hated the way that it did it because of the fact that it's erratic. If that was real, then it would be falling constantly. Like, obviously there has to be a gap so you can move, but be like a millisecond, there'll be like a gap, then a pattern, then it'll fall randomly, because the shadows don't increase in this game. You don't expand as the rock comes closer to you, so you don't know when to shield other than to guess the timing for it. There was a reason why I picked up the fairy in a bottle, and it's to do this. You can do it in such a manner where you can get both of them at once if you're really quickly. The safer route is to go ahead and go for the heart piece first here, if you really want the heart piece. You don't have to get it until you're an adult if you want to wait, but you have 30 some seconds when you come in here. You can get it at once if you run for the heart piece first. I get a feeling that it'll be a little bit quicker if I use the Deku Shield. I'm not even positive on that, by the way, so don't even take my word for it, but maybe if I walked backwards in here, it would have actually cut a little more time off. But yeah, now I've got a heart piece. I guess you could jump in the lava and it would reset you to the way that you came in. Maybe I can still make it. I've got 8 seconds. I can probably do it. 5, 4. Oh, fuck. Ah, damn it. Alright, so that's what happens if you run out of a timer ever. You just, you game over and that's it. But if you have a fairy, then you can revive yourself, but. Ah. Shit. There goes my shield. I don't know, that's twice I've lost the shield in the video, so whatever. But it happens. Whatever. That didn't count as a game over because I had a fairy. So I get to revive all my hearts and everything else. I'm not even sure if a timer stays on screen after you revive yourself. I think it may just reset. But whatever. That's I guess if you never saw that happen before, then that's what happens if you mess it up. I'm trying to get out of an area and a certain amount of time. It is possible to do that area and get a heart piece without hitting the timer. There's a variation of options, I guess, around through them. It's the first time that you ever go in for there, like go into that area, you run right away and go for the heart piece and you'll have enough time to get out. And then you can weave, go out, come back in again, timer resets, you have 32 seconds to get a skull chula. And another one would be to walk backwards the moment that you come in. I always get a heart piece when I'm a child. I consider it to be one of the child heart pieces. Just because it's there. It's right there in front of you when you're a kid. You can run and get it. There's no excuses why you shouldn't. And if you die, then have a fairy and have your Hylian shield equipped, obviously. I have to go back down to Kakariko. I'm just gonna use the owl, because it's gonna be that much faster. I remember the first time seeing this. This is probably one of the most memorable owl travel segments for the entire game. You only get to travel with the owl when you're a kid. The owl is never there, present to speak to you when you're an adult. Other than one time, I think it's in a cinematic in the desert. And that's pretty much it. There's nothing that actually encodes the conversation with the owl when you're an adult, I believe. How many skill chillers do I have? 20. So I can get one little upgrade from here, which is the Stone of Agony, which I don't really need. But other than that, I'm pretty much done with this video, I guess. Might as well just leave and go outside. And that'll be it, really. Yeah, there's nothing. I can't think of anything that I need to do here in Kakariko. Guess I could go ahead and walk back to Procure Forest and get a new shield, but whatever. So thanks for watching, guys, and see you guys next time. Thanks and goodbye.